What?!
Oh my gosh, I don't know how to use my own phone.
Well, that's what happens when you tamper in the domain of dual conversion technology.
Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know what? I'm actually doing kind of okay. So I wanted to make a follow-up about the UltraStudio Mini Recorder because I've been getting some feedback from not only Brainiac Brent, but other people in the tech community, which is another reason why I love doing these tech video logs. I love you guys. So if you have not seen the previous episode where I set this up on location with Brainiac Brent, check it out. All right, assuming that you've seen it by now, here's the problem. And this is a spoiler. So if you haven't seen the other episode, watch it now. I plugged this in to my computer to capture an SDI source and convert it to Thunderbolt. Basically, it lets me use any SDI or HDMI source like a webcam on steroids for live streaming, capturing, whatever. But I noticed after I had the feed up for a while, the video would start to drift and the audio would be very out of sync. So I was like, why is this happening? The theory is that I'm pushing too much through the pipe. I use Open Broadcaster as my streaming software, and Open Broadcaster uses X264 software as the H264 encoder. Basically, it wasn't able to keep up in real time while converting, I believe, a 10-bit SDI signal being pushed, probably with ProRes. I don't know if it sends ProRes over SDI, but I think it does. Basically, high-end video data was being pushed through SDI from the beefy Blackmagic camera through this thing, through Thunderbolt, into OBS, and it was trying to convert it into H.264 through software in real time. And it worked for a while, but then as it started, you know, it's kind of like that I Love Lucy scene with the chocolates, you know? It started choking over time. It got to be too much, so there was drift. So, I have now two possible solutions, thanks to Brainiac Brent, the community, and just me using my old noodle. Let's take a look. Choo-choo, bitch. This was my first idea, and we're gonna test it now together. I think if I convert the SDI to HDMI, and then capture through HDMI, there will be less overhead for the X264 software to convert on the fly, thus eradicating the syncing issue. Let's try it out. So, we're gonna plug USB in to power the HDMI conversion technology. Wow, this is double conversion technology. Is this even allowed? So we're gonna plug that in to power it. We're gonna plug HDMI in it's hard to do this on an angle, to drive the HDMI signal. I feel like I'm missing something. Okay, I'm missing a couple things. All right, Thunderbolt to come out of here into the computer, and SDI to go into the UltraStudio. So, SDI goes in. HDMI. And Thunderbolt. This is just a dangly mess. Okay. Well, that's what happens when you tamper in the domain of dual conversion technology. I just realized that I already broke my plan. The SDI is not supposed to go into the UltraStudio, it is supposed to go into the converter. Okay, you know, just sit off to the side, nobody loves you. Okay, we're gonna go to the video thing, the desktop video setup, and we're gonna change the mini recorder settings to HDMI now. And now we're gonna open up the exact same OBS setup that was in that CCL episode where we noticed the syncing issue, and the exact same setup that was in the previous episode with the UltraStudio. No changes. So as you can see, this is actually all the information I see behind the camera because I don't have a clean feed turned on, so let me turn that on. There we go. And now as you can see, we will be getting our lovely video echo. So let's make sure our audio is set to the Blackmagic audio. Okay, so everything the camera receives as audio, which is everything that is in the XLR port on the system, is going to come through SDI, through HDMI, through Thunderbolt, and then into the computer. We are converting it a lot. and we'll basically use that as our source, and then we got the camera here, as you can see, with a little bit of delay on here. So let's sync it up. So I just need like a reference to sync here. Let's see. I have this awesome little application called No Budget Slate, which, you know, like a slate in a movie, you know, action, you know, whatever. That's basically what this is, except it's just a little iPhone app. So we'll use that as our syncing reference. So, ideally, when you see this flash on the screen, you should see the meters jump. That will ultimately give us an indication that everything is in sync. Typically, I have to sync everything up the first time, but then everything should stay in sync instead of drift. So we're gonna run a stress test and see if that's the case. So let's check this out. Here we go. Ready? All right, let's try that again. Okay, so the video is behind just a little bit, so we need to speed it up. So let's go to the video filters, go to the, That's not the video. The camera filters, excuse me. I mean, let's go to the async video delay parameters and set that to, like, I'm just gonna guess a random number, 600. And let's see how that works. That looked perfect. I saw the audio meters jump right when the light went on the slate, meaning that everything is synced up. So, what happened last time? Again, after 10 minutes or so, everything was out of sync. So let's stress test this for like 10, 15 minutes. I'm gonna come back and see if everything is still in sync. And by the way, that X264 thing I was talking about earlier, I was wondering if there were other encoding options to maybe do something more efficient, but X264 looks like to be the only encoder option inside of here. And that's what's handling the H.264. And external hardware encoders can be like, for H.264, like $500 or so. And I really don't want to do that. So I'm hoping I can use my existing conversion technology to make this work. So I'll revisit it in 10 minutes and see if it stays in sync. Well, it looks like it's out of sync already, but I was changing frame rates and stuff. Oh man, I don't know if I screwed it up while it was open. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's definitely off. All right, I'm gonna try relaunching, and I was also playing back some footage from the Blackmagic, which switched away from the recording mode into the playback mode, which might have screwed some stuff up too. So I'm not gonna touch the camera. I'm just gonna let it run, relaunch the program, and do a stress test. Okay, so the video is now ahead just a little bit. Again, we have to do that initial sync. Now it's ahead just a little bit. Isn't this fun? I mean, that looks pretty accurate, right? All right, we're just gonna stress test it right here. All right, ready? I don't know if it's just my eyes, but it looks like it's a teeny weeny tiny bit off. It's been running for probably well over 20 minutes now. It looks like it's a little bit off. I don't know, my eyes could just be crazy. I mean, it looks like it's still pretty spot on. I may have to look at the tapes. So anyway, yeah, that is way more in sync than the last solution of just going SDI into the UltraStudio into the computer with X264 doing the encode decode. So yay, that won, but we're not done yet. When I mentioned this solution to Brainiac Brent, him being way smarter than me, but still losing in that guy's poll, that wasn't fair. He actually said, why don't you just change the encoder setting to hardware? So that's what I was showing you guys earlier. I was like, well, I can't because I go to the thing and it only has one option. But then I did some digging. If you change the output mode to advanced and then go to the encoder, there apparently is an Apple VT H.264 hardware encoder option. What? That was there this whole time? No one I talked to, no commenter, no forums I ever read, no one and nothing said that was there except for Brainiac Brent. I'm not demoting anyone. Everyone helped. Everyone was very nice. Some of the forums were kind of useful, but no one mentioned this to me except for Brainiac Brent. I'm sure there's other people that knew that was out there, but son of a bitch, I didn't find that. Only from Brainiac Brent, so thank you. We're gonna test that next. So I'm gonna shut down the camera and everything else and rehook up the conversion technology where the HDMI converter is now out of the equation. We're gonna go right through SDI into the UltraStudio into Thunderbolt like the original configuration plan, but instead of using X264 software, we're gonna use Apple's VT H.264 hardware encoding. Let's take a look. Okay, so the other converter is now completely out of the question. This microconverter will sit to the side, and we will resume our setup. Let's go to the video setup. So now we're gonna switch from the SDI, or from the HDMI back to the SDI, again, like the original configuration, relaunch Open Broadcaster, and drumroll please. Exciting. Okay, so let's make sure the setting's saved. Output Apple VT HD64 hardware encoder. Bam. Let's get the initial sync point on here. What the heck? Oh my gosh, I don't know how to use my own phone. All right, let's try that again. Come on. Okay, why can't I swipe anymore? Okay, apparently the app just stopped working. We're gonna try that again. Yeah, I mean, that looks good. So it's synced up, we're on the hardware encoder. Let's stress test it for another 15 minutes, because usually by then you would have noticeable drift. So we'll do 15 minutes and come right back. Okay, so I ran this for about 15 minutes. Let's do a sync test. And you can see the slate flashed right when the audio meters jumped. So yeah, I think this is the best solution. Just use the frickin' hardware encoder setting. It was pretty simple all along. So thank you everyone that helped out and left your suggestions, especially Brainiac Brent, because you ultimately gave me the best solution that worked. So I'm calling this a win. And now I can resume live webcasts again, because now I don't have to use some cheap webcam or cheap microphone. I can use a beautiful, beautiful sounding Sennheiser microphone. Shotgun, and I can use a gorgeous Blackmagic Ursa Mini camera. So Blackmagic, you saved the day again, and again, thank you to everyone that helped me out, and I can't wait to do more live streams for you guys in the future. Catch the crazy and pass it on.